Hello, everyone, and welcome to another edition of Inside Guns with your host, me, the Yankee Marshal. You know, since the tragic events this July 4th, the parade shooting, we have been waiting, some of us in the gun community, to find out what tool did this little monster choose. You know, we've been told by the media and local law enforcement that he used a high-powered, they stressed that word, high-powered AR-15 style, not an AR-15, but AR-15 style assault rifle. And that confused a lot of us. We're like, well, what rifle would fit that description, and how did this little piece of crap get a hold of it? So we've been waiting, like I said, for days since the shooting. It seemed like they were really reluctant to let us know what it was, but they were very busy demonizing, you know, high-powered AR-15 style assault weapons. Well, now we know what the tool was. And I don't usually put a lot of emphasis on what tool monsters choose to be monsters with, but in this case, I think it actually is important. And instead of telling you myself here, I'll let you hear it from the horse's mouth, the actual, you know, the ruggedly handsome horse's mouth, that the local police department puts forward to satisfy the media.
Yeah, so in 2020, he bought four weapons. The weapon used in the July 4th attack, Kel-Tec SUB2000.
Yep, you heard correctly. What this monster chose to use was the all-new, high-powered AR-15-style assault rifle from Kel-Tec called the SUB-200. In all seriousness now, I think he meant SUB-2000, because I don't think there is a SUB-200. And I'm sure the sub, as the media and the police would be happy to tell you, probably stands for Sinister Urban Bloodbath 2000, you know, according to their logic. But that's what he chose to use. That was the high-powered AR-15 style assault rifle. Now, first off, you're going to ask, how did a kid like this get a hold of such an intricate weapon of war? You know, it's got to be ungodly expensive, right? Well, you know, I'm betting that either the Koch brothers or George Soros bought it for him, probably, you know, knowing how the media works and what they say. But let's be serious here. This is not in any way a high-powered rifle. It is either in 9 or 40. I don't think they told us what caliber this one is. It's in a handgun caliber. It is not an AR-15 style rifle. It's black. It has a trigger and sights. But otherwise, nothing like an AR-15. This is basically a handgun that's been made out of a pipe sawed in half, where half the pipe is used as sort of a stock. It's more of a long-barreled handgun with a pistol with a stock on it than it is a rifle. I don't even know if it qualifies really to be a rifle in any of the meaningful ways. Legally, yes, but meaningful ways? I don't think so. This is just nothing that they portrayed it as. It's definitely not an assault weapon. It is a cheap piece of junk from Kel-Tec. I mean, and by junk, I mean it's just not well made. It works, but it's not well made. It's nothing you would take pride in owning. It's just a very practical, fun little gun that's made for plinking. Like I said, it's 9mm or 40. But you know what? Saying that a little pistol caliber carbine did all this damage doesn't suit the narrative of media and law enforcement. They want to demonize a certain type of gun so that they can justify removing those guns from the market. They have invested a lot of time and money in convincing you that these certain types of rifles, these assault rifles, these, you know, high-powered guns are just so dangerous that people, if they don't have them, they can't really commit any types of carnage. So we can just take those away and everyone will be fine. And I'm sorry for my voice going in and out during this. I'm still recovering my voice. But that's their MO. They're trying to demonize semi-automatic black rifles by labeling them things like high-powered, you know, high-capacity, you know, AR-15-style, you know, assault weapons, those kind of things that just aren't true. Those descriptions don't fit this gun at all. if they actually admitted what this gun was, it would kind of hurt their narrative that if you just take away these guns, the guns that are, you know, the ones that would be most useful if there was ever any type of rebellion or, you know, in this country whatsoever against, you know, powers foreign or domestic, the ones that would be the most useful. That's what they want to get out of people's hands first. And I mean first, not, that's not the only ones they want to get out of your hands. Those are the ones they want to get out of your hands first. So they try to tie them to all these killings, saying that if it wasn't for these guns, these killings wouldn't happen. If you look back in the old days, when we didn't have these guns, there weren't as many killings. Well, there was just as many back in the old days. In fact, if you look at a chart like murder rates by guns, hasn't changed much since 1968. The only difference is now these guns are more popular. More people have them. You know, the guy in the bell tower didn't use an AR-15 because they didn't exist at the time. If they did, he probably would have used one. It would have been the most common gun at the time. They're wanting to try to tie this fake increase in gun deaths, which is fake, to a specific type of gun so they can demonize it and convince people that if those just went away, we'd all be safe. We wouldn't really be taking away any gun people's gun rights because they'd still have other guns. They just wouldn't have that one that's responsible for so many deaths. Truth is, a bad person can do bad things with numerous different tools. You know, one of the other things he bought was a hunting rifle. He could have picked people off with a hunting rifle. Bad people can do bad things. He could have made a pipe bomb for the parade, like the marathon bombers did. He could have done anything. But like I said, that doesn't fit the media's narrative to admit that the tool isn't really the problem, but the little pieces of shit that are using the tools are the problem. And once again, in this situation, we see multiple choice chances where police had opportunities to intervene, and not just police, but local health officials, mental health officials, etc. The parents could have sent him to counseling, but instead they just chose to ignore it and let it happen. So I wanted to point this out today in this little kind of whimsical way here about the new Kel-Tec, that they're not trying to actually stop violence or stop deaths. They're trying to demonize a specific type of firearm so that they can be justified removing it. And then when they remove it and there's no real change in the murder rates, which there won't be because there hasn't been in a very long time, they'll lie and say that, oh, they're still going up or they're staying the same. So now we got to take away handguns that hold a lot of rounds. No one needs anything but a revolver, right? And then eventually it'll be like, wow, all we have is revolvers and people are still dying. We need to get rid of those. That's their game plan. Pay attention. Now, they've been stymied a little bit by the Second Amendment. So now they're shifting their resources towards other ways of getting rid of guns in communities, but they're not giving up on this right away. They're still hoping they can carve out an exception, that they can get people and the government and the courts to uphold that AR-15s and these other high-powered weapons of war that they love to say, which I don't remember, know a lot of soldiers carry Kel-Tecs, but these weapons of war don't hold a place in our country. They're not protected by the Second Amendment because they're made purely for destruction and death, and citizens shouldn't have them. That's their goal. They're not letting go of that. They're still holding out hope for that. But like I said, they're shifting most of their efforts towards other means, but that one, they're not going to let go of. So when you hear them demonizing these weapons, pay attention, because that's what they're trying to do. They're not trying to make anyone think poorly of the shooter or of what happened or anything like that. And they definitely don't want them asking questions like, well, why weren't steps taken when he showed all these signs? What they want them to do is go, ooh, look at that black, scary, high-powered AR-15 style assault weapon that no one should have. That's what they want. And they're kind of getting it in a way because a lot of people let them do this crap. But I think this is one example we need to latch onto and point out their hypocrisy and their lies and their end goal, because this exposes their agenda perfectly. So everyone out there, pay attention to this, learn from this, and contradict this. Let everyone you know this is the bullshit the media and the police are trying to pull, and it's not to make us safer, It's to disarm us so that they're safer when they violate our rights. All right, everybody, that's it for me today. I hope you enjoyed the show. I do appreciate you coming, and I hope to see you again tomorrow. Until then, I just want to remind everyone out there to always carry and stay safe until I see you again.